Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. Here's the first 7 crucial things to set up when your very exciting new MacBook arrives, just like this M2 Air here. And it seems like many of you have picked one up based on the comments from the previous video, so let's jump right into this video here. So once you've taken the new MacBook out of the box and the initial setup is done, the very first thing that I like to do is install the free battery health app here. It's a really useful app that shows detailed stats and health information on your brand new Mac's battery. And the reason I like to install this straight away is because it's an easy way to check that your new battery is healthy and working as it should. The last thing you want is to receive a new MacBook with, you know, battery defects. And it's happened before to some people in the past, even though it's rare. So I think it never hurts to be safe than sorry. A heads up that most MacBooks that come out these days should see an average cycle count of 1000, and that means you can charge it 1000 times until the battery should be replaced on average, or you'll start to see it deplete a lot faster. So the battery app, getting it straight away helps you check things like cycle count, the age, charging wattage, and the overall health of the battery, so you can keep using your shiny new MacBook for much longer. Then the next thing I do is set up Spotlight, and I love using the Spotlight shortcut for basically a lot of different things and basically everything. So if I want to bring up, let's say, the App Store really quickly instead of moving the trackpad, you know, I'll bring up Spotlight with Control Spacebar and then type in app and then quickly press enter. So to supercharge Spotlight though, and to make things even faster on your new MacBook, go to System Preferences, Spotlight, and then from here, untick the things you don't want Spotlight to search for. So for example, I don't want it to go through my mail and messages, movies, fonts, that sort of stuff. So I'll untick all of that. And what happens is Spotlight has less things to now index and search through, so it fetches search results much faster. You can even set up out of bounds search areas in the privacy tab if you want to hide, you know, who knows what. I'll leave that up to the imagination to the comments below. Also, fun tip, you can actually run calculations and conversions on Spotlight too, just like this, and even convert pounds to kilograms, for example, right here, which saves a load of time. Speaking of saving time and doing things much faster, the next thing to do is to set up extra keyboard shortcuts to speed your life up. So go to System Preferences, Keyboard, Shortcuts, App Shortcuts, and then click the plus icon here. Then you can set up shortcuts to your favorite apps or toggle on off other system shortcuts that you might not want to use. A great one that I like having, for example, is quickly bringing up a browser through a shortcut. So if you use Google Chrome like I do, you could set up Option Command G here to bring up Google Chrome. Just make sure that the shortcut you create doesn't conflict with anything else. It doesn't conflict with system shortcuts. So make sure that you actually give it a go and test it out before you actually set the shortcut. And also don't forget the native shortcuts app. It lets you combine multiple apps and steps together to create really useful automations. A good shortcut to have is setting up low power mode to kick in when you're under, let's say, 30% battery. Moving on, make sure to set up focus modes if you haven't yet already. I find it the easiest way to manage notifications without turning everything off. So to do this, you go into settings, notifications and focus, and then into focus. This is where you can set up focus modes for certain times of the day and only certain notifications will appear. It's really, really useful if you're using your new MacBook for both, you know, work, personal, and also play. I've got mine to set up work mode to start at 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. every weekday here. So only certain work app notifications will pop up through and certain people will get through to me. Otherwise, it's heads down, thumbs up. Then I have personal mode that kicks in after 6 p.m. and that's when all the personal notifications that I've missed throughout the day comes up and I can start replying to them if I need to. And then there's finally sleep mode, which is almost pretty similar to do not disturb mode. And I also have the share across devices box ticked right here. So it's the same across all my Apple devices that I use. Okie doke, so now that's done, the next thing that I find really useful to set up and make sure that the feature is turned on is the ability to send and receive text messages on your new MacBook. So that's green bubble messages, not just the blue bubble iMessages. So to do this, firstly, make sure that you signed into iCloud so you get everything synced across all your accounts and devices. Then on your iPhone, go to Settings, Messages, Text Message Forwarding. So here, select the devices that you want the text message to be forwarded to. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all my devices. So now I can start to sync, receive, and send messages directly from your Mac and also from your phone without reaching for your phone if you don't have it around. It's pretty useful. Next up, we cannot forget about backing up your MacBook. The last thing you want is to lose all your data and hard work if anything were to go wrong. So you can get your MacBook to completely automate backups by setting it up this way. So go to System Preferences, then Time Machine, and then select Backup Disk. I highly, highly recommend that you use an external storage drive for this. Otherwise, you're going to fill up your precious MacBook's drive super fast. So what I'm going to do is plug in an external SSD drive like this one here. And then I'm going to select the drive once it pops up. And then make sure you tick backup automatically too, so you can set and forget. The next thing you want to do here is click options and then select backup while on battery. That's pretty important, so it doesn't unnecessarily drain your battery life when you're out and about. It's also worth excluding folders from your backup that you don't need or want backed up to save precious, precious space from being eaten up. Then here are some essential Mac apps to get right off the bat. Google Chrome is a must for me personally. There's a lot more functionality and plugins with Chrome that I highly recommend using. Plus, the Moment dashboard makes for an absolutely beautiful homepage whenever you open up a new tab, and that's a great example of a plugin that I use on Chrome. Then there is Magnet, which is a lifesaver if you're a multitasker, especially if you're planning to dock your MacBook like this here. It helps you snap your windows into all sorts of preset areas on your screen with quick shortcuts like Control Option Spacebar. And then there's also Control Option Right for a split screen, right or left. And then you also have Silicone Mini Player. This is one to get for music and podcast lovers, and it's an app that controls all music players in a single place that I like having up most of the time, and it looks absolutely beautiful. And then finally, for all the fellow business owners and digital marketers out there, you'll want to set up Aphrodite.io, an ad analytics tool who, for full transparency, I am partnered with. If you use Facebook, Google, Bing, or LinkedIn ads at all, you're going to love this tool because it frees you from one app that I personally don't like using, which is Excel. Aphrodite has a bunch of cool tools like automated reporting, daily updates and recommendations, fast HTML5 advanced charts, and other data visualization tools, not just with Facebook ads, but most other ad platforms. And so having that omnipresent view of all your business and marketing through Aphrodite gives you insights way more efficiently than the traditional dashboard does. It's a tool that I don't go without, and I make sure that I basically bookmark it as soon as possible on all the Macs that I use. If you want to check out the tool and give it a go for yourself, there is a link down below to an extended free trial so you can start to dig around and see what sort of data your ad account holds. There are a load more essential apps that I install onto all my new Macs. So what I'll do is I'll leave a video on the screen here to the top 14 must-have starter Mac apps right here. And if you made it to the very end of this video, drop the code word comment sparkly, like your sparkly new Mac, and I'll give it a like. Drop a like if you enjoyed this video, of course, and enjoy your new MacBook. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.